Leslie Sun. In this video, I'd like to talk about some of the comments that I've received on my Venus Angelic 100 Chicken Nugget Challenge video. It's one of my most hated videos. I don't think I've got a video where I've got about half likes and half dislikes. And it's not really that I care about the dislikes, it just means that more people are watching my videos than just my subscribers. And I think that's a good thing to not just target your subscribers, but people who probably would never subscribe to you, but just stumble upon your videos and they're fans of someone else and you made a video about who they're a fan of. So I know that my videos are reaching other people and I'm really happy about that. I just wanted to read out some of the comments and respond to them because maybe you're a YouTuber who has gotten some comments that are not so favorable. And I just want to say that you don't have to feel bad about these comments. If you're making content that you know is valuable to other people and you want to reach to other people who might not be subscribed to you, then you have to expect that you'll get comments like these and not everyone will like you, but that's okay. As long as you believe in what you're doing, then keep doing that. So one of the recent comments that I got was by Rosie Summer, and she said, "In the meantime, while Venus was going through abuse and planning her escape from her mother, well done, Lee-san, for putting shame on an abused person. Clap, clap, clap. I am not shaming Venus through that video. I was merely pointing out the cruelty in her actions. And it is up to that person to feel ashamed about it if they know that they're doing something wrong. Shame is a normal feeling if you feel guilty about doing something that you know was not right. That's just completely normal. It's not whether I was shaming her. It's just pointing out the wrongdoing, and normally change comes through an emotion. Like, if you don't feel ashamed about what you're doing, then it is unlikely that you'll change. So unfortunately, a negative emotion will be part of change sometimes, and it doesn't always feel good for me to be the one pointing out the wrong of someone else. But if we want to change the world, if we want to change other people, it does help to criticize them. And it's not always about leading by example. Leading by example is great, and of course you have to lead by example if you are criticizing others. So you can't just be a hypocrite and not do what you say to do. But if you're in a position where you have the education, the knowledge, the experience to see that someone else is going down the wrong path and is not doing anything that is helpful to them and is harming their bodies, then if you point that out, I don't see anything wrong with that. And especially if it's done in a kind way, as was in my video. I didn't swear at Venus, I didn't call her any names, I just pointed out the things that she was doing wrong. I gave the information and I gave alternatives. So it was a very informational, educational video. Here's another comment that I got. This was not someone who was subscribed to me before, but this is what she said. "I agree with all your opinions. While watching her videos, I actually ran into your comment and I'm very happy with your video." So this is someone who wasn't subscribed to me, but ran into my video just because of the title. And they became vegan soon after. And they said that I was one of the people who inspired them to become vegan, and I'm really honored that my video prompted that. So it's not always negative things, and that comment made everything so worthwhile. So any hate comment that I get, I don't really care about, as long as I know that I'm changing someone's life. If I know that my video is reaching people who would otherwise not know about veganism or even how to do a vegan diet properly, if I know my videos are reaching that kind of audience, then it doesn't really matter what hate I get. And you can't really consider that hate. It's just words on the internet, and I really don't let it bother me. If it does bother me, it bothers me to a point where I'm more inspired to make videos. It doesn't stop me from making the kind of videos that I want to make. "You probably mean well, but criticizing other people's eating habits is not the way to change the world." And I responded by saying, it does change people who watch and learn. Of course, YouTube videos only change the world to a certain extent. We're just reaching the people who watch the videos. Celebrity names or YouTubers' names in the titles will get views from people who watch those people or who are interested in their lives. So it's not so much targeting that particular YouTuber, but the people who are their fan base. And it's not meant to be an insult to the YouTuber you're talking about. It's meant to be a way to reach a wider audience. To say that criticizing other people's eating habits is not a way to change the world is just wrong, because you can change the world doing that. You might not be able to change the whole world, but you can do something. If people look into the information that's provided in my videos, they will learn more. And my videos aren't simply name-calling or criticizing without giving any solutions. In every video that I do that criticizes someone else, I always offer an alternative. I always offer other websites to go and check out the research on a vegan diet. So people just need to look into those things more and to not take my videos so personally. Someone also said she is trying to be Freely, and they were talking about me, and I said, I'm not trying to be Freely, even if that was a bad thing. I think Freely is amazing, and I am so glad that she's reaching so many people. She's reaching millions of people around the world, and she's changing so many lives. Other YouTubers criticize the way that Freely does her videos. Why do we have to criticize other people who are doing their best to change the world?